the old fort that they had back in the Second World War, I think it was. They had the old cannon and stuff you can look up if you want. And the little grassy area over there, that's where James Cook landed. It was originally meant to be Cronulla, but he didn't like the area, so he sailed up here, and there you go. Over that way you got the airport and the seaport. Over that way you got the big entry. There's a couple of different ones, like got Kaima and Newcastle, I think it is. Anyways, take a bit of a look over there a little bit later, yeah? Little friends. The airport's just over that little bridge thing there. You're right, the city's all the way over there. You can see the sky tower, or sky tower, whatever it is. Here in Sydney. could be a fancy cafe right there. It's important in the bridge. Suburb named after Lapérouse. Can't remember if he's a captain or a lieutenant, but he's originally from France. And up that way, the walk up there will be after. Got his original house and one of the first forts that was built here. Old museum here. It's not open today. Maybe next time when I come out, go inside. An old cannon sitting on it back in the day, and that would have all the old shells and whatnot for it. So evergreen chip, I think that was the one that got stuck up in the Middle East somewhere, I think it was. little castle look like. That was one of the first ones to be built by Lapérouse himself. Time to get back on the bus. See you soon. Ciao. Of England, they're used for the bow and arrows, but they look like air ventilation nowadays. There you got some history there by the Bank Tower. It'd be cool to get inside of it.